Hello friends, in last lecture we started the factorization, so let us continue with the same. So here is the very first question for this lecture, that is we have to factorize. So first question is x cube plus 6x square, x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 16 plus 12x plus 16. We have to find the factors of the given expression. So think for a while that how you will proceed, then I will give you its solution. Okay, so let us see how to solve this. See, here we have x cube plus 8x square plus 12x. Now, if I try to find common from first two, yes, it is possible to take common. So, from first two, I am taking common x square. Okay, if I take x square common, here I will get x plus 6. Now, from next two, again it is possible to take something common. I can take 4 common, so I will get 3x plus 4. Now here you can see these two brackets have different quantities. That means it is not possible to take common further, and hence it is not possible to factorize it further. Definitely, it means we have to change our strategy. By this method, it is not possible to factorize it. So now here I am finding it is a cube. Okay, this is definitely not a cube, but I can write this 16 in two terms, among which definitely one will be cube. So I will start like this: x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8 plus 8. I can also write plus 1 plus 15, but here I started with 8 plus 8. This 8 is perfect cube. Okay, so now I will try to adjust these terms in terms of identity of a cube plus b cube or a plus b whole cube. So that's why I am writing this 8 over here, this 6x square plus 12x plus 8. Okay, so now these four terms I will try, that this four terms gives me an identity. So let me write the terms in the form of identity. So a cube plus b cube plus 3 into a into b to a plus b. Okay, first two terms I wrote according to identity, and this left and third term I just wrote by considering this as a and this as b. Now definitely I do check whether the multiplication of this or the simplification of this is this or not. So here it is 6x into x, 6x square, 6x into 2, 12x. Yes, it is okay. So now first three terms are definitely going to give you x plus 2 whole cube, and this 8 again can be written as 2 cube. So again I got the identity of a cube plus b cube. Now identity of a cube plus b cube gives you a plus b, then a square plus b square minus AB in this way. So here I will simplify this. So here x plus 4, over here x square plus 4 plus 4x plus 4. Okay, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now 2 square is 4, over here it is minus 2x minus 4. This minus 4 plus 4 will cancel out. So here I will get x plus 4. Now over here x square, now 4x, yes, that is only minus 2x, so I do write 2x and plus. So these are the final factors of the given expression. Now here this is a quadratic polynomial or quadratic expression. Here again we have to check whether it is possible to factorize it further or not. For that we do apply this, b square minus 4ac. I will check with this whether the b square minus 4ac is a complete square or not. So b square, that is 1 square. Sorry, b square, that is 2 square. Minus 4 into a is 1, c is 4. So 4 minus 16. Here we are getting actually negative term. So if as we are getting negative, that means it is not possible to factorize this quadratic polynomial further. So this is my final answer. So please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Next is x cube minus 1 upon x cube. Cube minus 1 upon x cube plus 2 upon x plus 2 upon x minus 2x plus 2 upon x minus 2x. Okay, so you have to find the factors of this. So let us see how to solve this. See, here it is. I can say a cube minus b cube. So definitely I can take, I can apply the identity. So a cube minus b cube is actually a minus b into a square plus b square plus ab. So here I will apply that identity. So this is a cube minus b cube. So it should be a minus b, then a square plus b square plus ab. Okay, plus ab. Over here, if I take 2 common, I will get 1 upon x minus x. Okay, 1 upon x minus x. So here I will get, now here you can see 1 upon x minus. Okay, so. Okay, here I have x minus 1 upon x, and here I have 1 upon x minus x. So if I make a small change, instead of plus 2, if I take minus 2 common, so I will get the same thing in the bracket. Okay, I am writing this as it is. Plus 1, okay, x and x will cancel out. Here I am taking minus 2, and I am rewriting this in this way, so that I can get these two quantities look alike, and hence I can take this as a common. So when I take this common, what I left with, x square plus 1 upon x square plus 1 minus 2. And hence, here I am writing my final step. This x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. So this is the final answer. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, let us see the next question. Okay, now next question is 8 upon 27 x cube plus 1 plus 4 upon 3 x square plus 2 x. Okay, so think for a while that how you will factorize this, then I will give you the solution. Okay, so here again I think that should must be clicked to you. See, this is a complete cube, this is a complete cube. So whenever you find two complete cube, you can think about the identity of a plus b whole cube. For that, what I will do, first of all I do write the first two terms in the form of exact cube, and then remaining two terms I do write as per the identity of a plus b whole cube. So here I can write this 2x upon 3 whole cube, this as 1 cube. Okay, now here I got a cube plus b cube. Now a cube plus b cube is a plus b whole cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. That means after this there should be plus 3 AB. Now I am not checking this, as I consider this as A, this as B. So according to that, after A cube plus B cube, I must have 3 into A into B in the bracket A plus B. Okay, now definitely I do check whether the product of these is these two terms or not. So this is, if I multiply 3 and 3 will cancel out, I can say 2x into 2x, 4x square upon 9. Okay, so here I am not getting 4x square upon 9. So okay, a cube plus b cube plus 3 into a into b into a plus b. And 3 will cancel out, 4x upon 3. Okay, 3 and 3 will cancel out, so 4x square upon 3 only will be there, not 9, because this 3 and 3 will cancel out. So yes, I am getting 4x square by 3, and over here when I multiply 3 and 3 will cancel out, 2x into 1, that is 2x. That means if I do write these two terms in this way and first two term in this way, that gives me exactly the identity of a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. That can be written as a plus b whole cube. So this is the final answer. Okay, 2x plus 2x upon 3 plus 1 whole cube. So please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now let us see the next question. Okay, now next question is 3x minus 2y whole cube, 3x minus 2y whole cube plus 5y minus 9z, 5y minus 9z whole cube plus 9z minus 3x. So here it is 5y plus 9z minus 3x whole cube. You have to find the factors of this. So here just I'm giving you a hint. This might be in the form of a cube plus b cube plus c cube. So over here you must click the identity of a cube plus b cube plus c cube. So think for a while as I give you the hint, then I will give you its solution. Okay, so here it is a cube plus b cube plus c cube. So whenever you get the identity of a cube plus b cube, whenever you get the sum of the cubes of three terms, first thing that you should check whether the sum of those three terms is zero or not. Because if a cube plus b cube plus, sorry, if a plus b plus c equal to zero, okay, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then we know that a cube plus b cube plus c cube can be written as 3a into b into c. Okay, so over here if I consider this as a, this as b, and this term as c, so first thing I have to check whether their sum is 0 or not. So let us see. However, that can be written orally. Okay, here it is minus 9z, here it is plus 9z, cancel. Minus 3x plus 3x, cancel. Minus 5y plus 5y, cancel. So definitely sum is 0, but let me do it for you in a proper way. Okay, so let 3x minus 5y is equal to a, 5y minus 9z is equal to b, and 9z minus 3x is equal to c. Now a plus b plus c is equal to 3x minus 5y plus 5y minus 9z plus 9z minus 3x. Therefore a plus b plus c is equal to 0. Okay, you can cancel these all. As a plus b plus c 0, therefore I can write a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc according to the conditional identity. Whenever we will get the sum of three quantities is 0, sum of the cubes of those three quantities will be 3 times the product of those three terms abc. Therefore, now we will replace the values of abc actually what it were. So 3x minus 5y cube plus 5y minus 9z cube plus 9z minus 3x cube is equal to 3 into 3x minus 5y, 5y minus 9z, 9z minus 3x. So this is the final answer. Okay, that was the question, that we have to find the factors of this. So factors of this are 3 into this into this into this. So please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, next. Okay, next is 4a square plus 12ab, 4a square plus 12ab plus 9b square minus 8a plus 12b minus 8a minus 12b. Okay, so think for a while that how you will find the factors of this expression, then I will give you its solution. Okay, so if you observe carefully over here, first three terms might be square of any quantity or any other expression. Okay, so here I can write it 2a whole square plus 2 into 2a into 3b plus 3b whole square minus 8a minus 12b. So this will be 2a plus 3b whole square, isn't it? 2a plus 3b whole square. Now from these I can take minus 4 common, so 2a plus 3b, isn't it? Minus 8a minus 12b. Now again you can take 2a plus 3b common. So if I take 2a plus 3b common, here I will get 2a plus 3b minus 4. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now let us see the next question. Okay, next is 5 minus 3x square minus 2x. 3x square minus 2x. 6 minus 3x square plus 2x. Okay, so how to find the factors of this thing for a while, then I will give you its solution. Okay, let us see how to simplify this or how to find the factors of this. See, if you observe carefully, here it is 3x square minus 2x, and in this particular term, that means this part, again we have 3x square and 2x. Definitely they are in opposite sign. So very first thing what I will do, I will try to make it same. So two things can be done. Either I take common minus sign common from here to make it 3x square minus 2x, or simply if I take minus sign common over here. So here I am taking minus sign common, so in this way I am writing it 2x, or I am writing it minus 3x square plus 2x. Okay, and this I am writing as it is, it is 6 minus 3x square plus 2x. Okay, so this will become 5 minus minus plus minus 3x square plus 2x, and over here I have 6 minus 3x square plus 2x. Now minus 3x square plus 2x, that I am writing or replacing by y. So let me add one more step. Here I am writing 2x minus 3x square 6 plus 2x minus 3x square. Okay, now suppose 2x minus 3x square is equal to y. So what I will get? 5 plus y, 6 plus y, isn't it? What I did, I simply replaced 3x minus 2x minus 3x square by y. So 5 plus y into 6 plus y, this is y. So what I will get over here? 5 plus 6y plus y square. Or if I do write it in standard form, this will become y square plus 6y plus 5. So this is a quadratic expression, or I say quadratic polynomial. Okay, we know how to find the factors of this. Splitting the middle term, will see that in a, we'll come to this later on, that how to split the middle term. But right now I hope you are ready with the basic steps. So first what I will do, I have to find the factors of the constant term, okay, multiplied by coefficient of first term. So that is 5, and now I will find the factors of 5, that are 5 and 1 only. Okay, now I have to use these factors to get 6. So if I add these two, if I do write y square plus 5y plus y plus 5. Okay, so definitely I will get 6y, as well as their product is 5y square. That means these two terms are exactly correct. Now I can take y common from first two, so y plus 5, and I can take plus 1 common from next two, so again y plus 5. So here I will get y plus 5, y plus 1. Okay, y plus 5, y plus 1. Okay, so these are the factors, but we have to find the factors of this, not the this. That means now what I have to do, I will replace the value of y, and value of y was 2x minus 3x square. So here I do write 2x minus 3x square plus 5. Over here again 2x minus 3x square plus 1. Now to split or to find the factors of these two further, first of all let me write in the standard form. That means here I do write minus 3x square plus 2x plus 5, over here again minus 3x square plus 2x plus 1. Now we also keep one thing in our mind, that means the first term must be positive. So for that what I will do, for that, okay, I have to take minus sign common. So if I take minus sign common, here I will get 3x square minus 2x minus 5. Okay, here again I have to take minus sign common. So if I take minus sign common, here I will get 3x square minus 2x minus 1. Okay, now this minus will become plus. So ultimately here I will get 3x square minus 2x minus 5, and over here 3x square minus 2x minus 1. Okay, now is it possible to find the factors of these two, because these two are again quadratic expressions? So for that we have to check with the b square minus 4ac. So first of all, note it down up to this point, then we'll see whether it is possible or not to factorize these two quadratic expressions further or not. ओके नाउ लेट अस सी वेदर इट इज पॉसिबल टू फैक्टराइज दीज टू फर्दर और नॉट. फॉर दैट द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग दैट आई विल फाइंड बी स्क्वायर माइनस फोर ए सी. ओके सो लेट मी फाइंड दैट बी स्क्वायर माइनस फोर ए सी. सो फॉर फर्स्ट बी स्क्वायर दैट इज माइनस टू स्क्वायर माइनस फोर इंटू ए इंटू सी दैट इज फोर एंड सिक्सटी फोर. यस दैट मीन्स इट इज पॉसिबल टू फैक्टराइज दिस फर्दर. ओके नाउ फॉर द सेकेंड अगेन बी स्क्वायर दैट इज दिस माइनस फोर इंटू ए इंटू सी दैट इज फोर प्लस ट्वेल्व सिक्सटीन. यस both are the perfect square. b square minus 4ac over here is 64 and over here it is 12. that means it is possible to factorize it further. so let us see how to do this. okay so here next step is I'm rewriting that step again. 3x square minus 2x minus 5 and over here 3x square minus 2x minus okay so over here you have to find the factors of 5 into 3 15. okay so 15 that is 5 into 3 into 1 so we can go with this. so here I can write 3x square minus 5x plus 3x minus 5. okay so difference okay their addition is minus 2x and their product is minus 15x square. that means this is the correct combination. now we can proceed further. over here 3x square minus 3x plus x minus 1. okay so here you will get minus 2x and product is minus 3x square. okay so this is absolutely correct. now from these two I can take common x. so if I take x common here I will get 3x minus 5. from here I can take one common so 3x minus 5. okay now further over here from these two I can take 3x common so x minus 1 and from these two I can take plus 1 common so x minus 1. so in this way we can factorize it further. okay now over here from these two I can take 3x minus 5 common so here I will get x plus 1. from these two I can take x minus 1 common so here I will get 3x plus 1. so these are the four factors of this given expression. okay so please note it down then we'll see the next question. okay so now we'll see next question. I'm giving you one more question of the similar type. okay so let us see. okay so next question is 2x square plus 5x 2x square plus 5x again 2x square plus 5x minus 19 plus 84. okay so this one we can say is little bit easier than the previous one because in the previous question the common expression was not given directly. after taking minus sign common, we make them same, and then we replace it by another variable, that is y. Here we can replace these two variables directly by y, and then we can proceed. So 2x square plus 5x over here, 2x square plus 5x minus 19 plus 84. So now suppose 2x square plus 5x is equal to y. So this gives me y, therefore y to y minus 19 plus 84. Okay, so here on multiplication I'll get y square minus 19y plus 84. Again here we directly got the quadratic polynomial. Over there, after taking something common, we got it in the standard form. Okay, now you have to think that how to factorize it further. For that, okay, as I told you, we'll definitely see this, how to factorize this quadratic polynomials, in a separate section. Okay, but over here I hope you are ready with the very few steps, that is to split the middle term. We have to find the factors of 84. So let us find the factors of 84. Okay, so factors of 84 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 1. Okay, so now using these factors you have to obtain 19. So think how or in which two group, in which two groups you will divide these factors to make sum as minus 19. Okay, so see, if I take this and this, so this will become 4 and 21. Their difference is not 19, neither their addition is 19. Now if I take these three together, so 12 and 7, yes, 12 plus 7 is 19, but here it is minus 19, so we'll go with minus 12 minus 7. So here further I can write y square minus 12y minus 7y plus 84. Okay, so from these two I can take y common, so y minus 12. From these two I can take 7 common, minus 7 common, so y minus 12. Okay, you can check it, minus 7y minus 7 into 12, 84. Okay, so now factors are y minus 12, y minus 7. Okay, so here again I will say this is not the final answer, because we have to find the factors of expression having x, and here it is y. So now what we will do, we'll put the value of y, whatever we assume, 2x square plus 5x. So I'm starting from here. So y minus 12, so 2x square plus 5x plus 12, sorry, minus 12, and 2x square plus 5x minus 7. Okay, 2x square plus 5x minus 12, 2x square plus 5x minus 7. So we need to find the factors of these two. Now again, before we proceed, we do check with the help of b square minus 4ac. So b square minus 4ac, for first one it is 25 minus 4 into 2 into minus 12, so 25 plus, yes, 121. We are getting 121, which is a complete square. That means it is possible to find the factors of this first one. Let us check for the second one. Again, it is 25 minus 4 into a into minus 7. So 25 plus 56. 81. Yes, it is again a complete square. So it is possible to find the factors of these two further. So let us see. Now, to find the factors of this quadratic expression, what we will do, we'll find the factors of a multiplied by c. That means we have to find the factors of 2 multiplied by 12, that is 24. So factors will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, now we have to adjust these factors in such a way that sum is 5. So here I can write 2x square plus 8x minus 3x minus 12. Okay, similarly over here I can write 2x square. Now here the term whose factor we have to find is 7 into 2, that is 14, and factors of 14 are simply 2 and 7. So we have to arrange these two in such a way that sum is 5. So that is 7 minus 2. So here I can write plus 7x minus 2x minus 7. Okay, so here it is 2x square. Now here we have to take common from first two and then from next two. So from first two you can see that we can take 2x common. When I take 2x common, here I will get x plus 4. Similarly from these two I can take minus 3 common, so I will get x plus 4. Okay, over here again from first two I can take only x common, so I will left with 2x plus 7. And from here I can take minus 1 common, so I will left with 2x plus 7. Okay, now from these two I can take x plus 4 common, so here I will get 2x minus 3. And from these two I can take 2x plus 7 common, so I will left with x minus 1. So these are the factors of the given algebraic expression or polynomial, whatever you say. So please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now let us see the next question. Okay, next question is, three a square plus 2 upon b square plus 16 plus 2 root 6 a upon b minus 8 root 2 upon b minus 8 root 3. Okay, 3a square upon, plus 2 upon b square plus 16 plus 2 root 6 a upon b minus 8 root 2 upon b minus 8 root 3a. You have to find the factors of this. So think for a while that how you will proceed, which identity, which rule, and whatever concept you can apply. Think over that, then I will give it solution. Okay, so let us see its solution. See, very first thing that should come in your mind over here, see, this is definitely, it is not possible to take common from first two and next two and next two. Okay, so as well as this has six terms. Okay, so is there any identity which has six term after expansion? Yes. If I think about the identity a plus b plus c whole square, then it contains six term after expansion. That means it is possible that this expression is exactly the sum a plus b plus c whole square. But to get to know whether it is exactly in that form or not, I have to rewrite this in the form of its identity. Now, what is the identity of a plus b plus c whole square? It is, if you know the identity of a plus b plus c whole square, it is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Now, you might say this, here all the terms are positive, but here there are some terms which are negative. It is possible. If I take b as negative, then this will be negative, this will be negative, because b is negative, so product of a positive and negative will be negative, isn't it? So, first thing I have to check, there are two terms which are negative. Okay, if I consider this is exactly in the form of a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca, and here last two are negative, so here you can see last two have c common. That means here this c must be common. That means instead of c, this is c square. Okay, if I compare this is a square, this is b square, and this is c square. That means I have to write this term in a such a way that c becomes negative. That means I have to write 16 as minus of 4 square. Okay, so now what I will do, see, this is definitely not a complete square, but still it is possible to write in the form of complete square. Here I can write a root 3 whole square. Similarly, over here this 2b is 2 upon b square is again not a complete square, but I can write it root 2 upon b whole square. Here this can be written as minus 4 whole square. Okay, why I am writing minus 4? Because I am finding one of the term is two terms are negative. Now one thing more, if you observe here, it is b and a. Okay, they are negative, so if I make b negative, then this also should be negative. Okay, so b and a, so better to take this minus 4 as the negative, c square as the negative. So here I do write this as a root 3 whole square plus root 2 upon b whole square, a square plus b square plus c square. Only first three term I wrote by my own. Now remaining three terms I do write as per the identity. Now, identity of a plus b plus c whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab. So, I do write plus 2a according to me is a root 3 into b according to me is root 2 upon b. Now, before I proceed, I do check whether the product of these three terms is this term or not. So, it should be 2 into root 3 into root 2, that is root 6. So, 2 root 6 a upon b. Yes, it is 2 root 6 a upon b. Definitely, as the I got this term is correct, definitely remaining two terms are going to be correct. So, a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab, now plus 2bc, 2 into b, that is root 2 upon b into c, that is minus 4. Again, before I proceed, I do check whether the product of these three is 8 root 2 upon b or not. Minus 8 root 2b upon or not. So, here it is minus, here it is plus. So, definitely product is negative. In the denominator b, here again in the denominator b. Now, numerator 2 into 4 into root 2, that is 8 root 2. That means this term is also correct. Now, minus 2ca, that is minus 4 into root, a root 3 into a root 3. So this is 8a root 3. Yes, it is 8a root 3. But there is a, okay, here it should be plus, because it is plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So ultimately it is minus 8a root 3. Here again we have minus 8a root 3. That means these term as a, b and c was the correct selection, and I can write the given expression in the form of a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca, which is actually equal to a plus b plus c whole square. So a plus b plus c whole square. Okay, so further I can write when I open this bracket, so a root 3 plus root 2 upon b minus 4 whole square. So these are the factors. That means this can be written as the product of a root 3 plus root 2 upon b minus 4 two times. So this is my final answer. So please note it down. So I hope you are getting these things. So you also understand that to find the factorization of any given expression, we need so many concepts altogether. We need to know how to take common. We need to know about the identities. Now you can see here we got the factorization by applying the identity of a plus b whole cube as well as a plus b whole square. The last question was a plus b plus c whole square. So factorization needs so many things. So I'm finishing this chapter, this lecture over here. Now in next lecture we'll see some more or different type of factorization. Till then, bye, thank you, take care, stay at